Okay, let's talk about the network layer. The network layer is it's the workhorse. It is what makes the internet work. So let's get talking. First, objectives. You're gonna know what the network layer's job is, what it does, how, a little bit about how it works, but mostly just be able to identify what the job of the network layer is, and also what is an IP address. We talk about IP addresses all the time. I mention them all the time. When you talk about network stuff, IP address goes out, everybody talks about IP addresses. Well, what are they? Who cares? By the end here, you should know the answer to that. So, again, this is it. The network layer, networking, inter-networking, connecting networks to each other. This is how the internet works. IP addressing and routing, which are the jobs of the network layer, are how the internet works, how devices are able to talk from New York to Japan, from Utah to Singapore. It doesn't matter. All of it happens using IP addressing, and all of it happens because the network layer does the routing to get packets across a dozen networks to get from point A to point B, wherever it is that you need to go. And that's it. I mean, that's the network layer's job. This is it. It makes the network work. Awesome stuff. So the network layer routes traffic from point A to point B. It's really just getting traffic, but routing is the term for getting traffic from point A to point B. It's choosing a path to get stuff where it needs to go. And it connects various networks to each other. Without the network layer, you can talk within a local area network. Most of that still happens with the network layer now. But before we had a network layer, an internet layer, and TCP/IP, and the internet protocol as we know it today, you could have communication within a local network. But you couldn't have communication between networks. And you need that communication between networks to be able to do the cool stuff that the network layer does. And that's what we really, I mean, to be able to do the cool stuff that the internet does. All the websites and emails and web video conferencing and online gaming and transferring files and Dropbox and all of those things function because you're able to connect to a local network, and then that network connects to another network, and that network connects to another network or a bunch of other networks, and through a web of networks, you might say, you can get traffic where you need to go. So that's what the network layer does. Now, what the network layer doesn't do is guarantee that things get there. The transport layer's job is to provide some level of assurity that things get where they need to go eventually. But the network layer doesn't care about that. The network layer provides no guarantees that things will get where they need to go. All it says is, I'll do my best. I'll try. If it doesn't work out, if things get lost, sorry, not my problem. That's somebody else's problem. TCP handles that at the transport layer. So the router is the workhorse of the network layer. Every device has an IP address. Everything has IP addresses. The router's the one that does what? Well, it does the routing, which is the job of the network layer. And you might have seen routers like this. And to be honest, this thing, it's a router, but barely. Because what this router does is just gets traffic off of your local network, out of a personal local network. And that's fine. You know, I mean, somebody's got to do it, and it's good that we have these devices. But routers like this big corporate, beefy corporate router, their job is to figure out traffic and paths among a bunch of networks. So this thing here knows about two networks. It knows about your local network and the outside network. That's it. Anything that's not for the local network gets sent to the outside network. That is all. We'll talk more about this when we talk about routing. But this device here knows about a bunch of different networks, knows the paths to a bunch of networks, networks it's connected to, networks that the networks it's connected to are connected to, and it is responsible for finding a path in a lot more complicated way than this that just handles two networks, essentially. This could handle 10 or 20 or 50 different networks. So that's where this beefy router comes into play. So how does it all work? It all works with IP addresses. IP addresses are the addresses and the information that matters at the network level, at the network layer. And an IP address is a logical address. And By logical and not physical, what I mean is your device has an IP address. When you connect to a network, you get an IP address, and we'll talk about DHCP and the process for getting an IP address, but you have an address on your local network at home. And if you take your laptop and take it to campus, or if you take your laptop and take it to work, or if you take your laptop and take it to Starbucks, your device is going to have a different IP address. And that IP address is assigned depending on what network you are a part of. And so that's what I mean by logical IP address. It's not physically attached to your device. It changes depending on where you are. And it represents a way to get to an address to connect to your device. And it's every single interface on a network needs an IP address. We'll talk more about that in just a second. So the way an IP address works is kind of like an address in a building. So if you think about an address in a building, typically it's kind of split into a couple different parts. There's the first part of the address in the building that represents what floor you're on. If you're on the first floor, it starts with a 1. If you're on the 26th floor, it starts with a 26. If you're on the 40th floor, it starts with a 40. So that from a glance, you can figure out which floor of the building an address is associated with. And that's fantastic. And then after you've got the first part that represents the floor that you're on, you have a room number that is unique to that room, and to help you find exactly what room you're going to. And IP addresses work in much the same way. So when you're talking about an IP address has two different parts as well. Just like the building address, floor address has two different parts, you've got two different parts of the network address or the IP address. And those are the network ID and the host ID. And those parts are separated by the subnet mask. And we will talk extensively about IP addressing and what addresses and how do you tell where the network address starts and where the host ID ends or begins. We will get into that extensively in other videos. So don't worry about that quite yet. Just know that the subnet mask is what tells you that the network ID and the host ID are both there and where they start and end. So what needs an IP address? I kind of already gave away the answer here, but we'll talk about it specifically here. Every single host interface on a network or an internetwork needs a unique IP address. So what does that mean? It means that some hosts might have more than one interface connected to the network. So if you have a router, for example, that's connected, remember your router at home is connected to an internal network and an external network. Well, that's two different interfaces, and that means that your router has two different IP addresses, one for the internal network, one for the external network. You might have a computer that's connected to multiple networks if it has multiple network interfaces, and you would do the same. Each of those interfaces, each network that it's connected to, needs its own IP address. And some interfaces, you just give more than one IP address for a variety of reasons, and we can talk about those some other time, but just know that it's possible for one network interface to have more than one IP address, and that does happen. And each network needs one unique network address. And when we talk about subnetting and how to split up networks and how to divide networks into a bunch of different networks, we'll get into exactly what that means. So here we have a network. Before we move on, pause the video, take a look. How many host addresses, how many IP addresses are needed for this network? Well, we'll get started the easy way. First, we have our five hosts, our five computers that are connected to the network. Each of those needs an IP address. So that's great. But then in addition to those, we also need an IP address for each interface on the router. So you've got two different routers in this network, this one over here, this one over here, and each of those routers is connected to two or even three different networks. So you've got one router interface connected to the network with those three hosts, one router interface here connected to these two hosts and this network, and then you've got this middle network connecting the networks, and each time you've got devices that are connected to each other, you've got a network. And if you've got a network between routers, that's its own network. So devices on that network need their own IP address. And finally, you've got the connection from this router that is a gateway router out to the outside world. And that needs an IP address as well. So here in this diagram, we need 10 different IP addresses, 10 different host addresses to make this work. We have three different networks plus the network to the cloud. So four different networks, one over here, this network, one over here, this network, these three, the router and these two devices, and then the one in between. And finally, the connection to the outside world, out to the internet, the mythical cloud. So before we go, check yourself. How many devices do you own that need an IP address? Look around, look at your devices. Maybe if you can get into it, look at your router settings and see how many IP addresses are there on your network. How many devices are connected that have an IP address? And what information is contained in an IP address? Something we talked about in this video. What is there in the IP address? Maybe think back to that subnet mask, and that is the network layer.